Hello everybody and welcome to a new video and welcome to... What is this called again? Moonbase Alpha or Alpha Moonbase? I couldn't read that quick enough.
Lunar Base Alpha, this is Research Team Beta. Over.
Copy that, Beta. Go ahead.
We're returning from the field. We should be back at the outpost in less than 5 minutes. Over.
Copy that, Beta. We'll see you in 5 minutes at Nav 1.
What? What was that?
Nav 1. Looks like we got hit by crumpet. Maybe a meteor strike. Smashed up the solar ring, something terrible, and knocked out the living quarters export system.
Beta, we need your help. We're running out of oxygen here. We need to get that solar ray online and the life support system repaired ASAP.
All the supplies you need should be in the equipment shed. Readings show the area around the life support system is too hazardous to approach on foot, so make sure to deploy repair robots. Please hurry.
Copy that, en route.
This is HQ. The meteor strike has crippled our base and shut down oxygen production. You need to repair the damage immediately. Here's how oxygen production works. The solar panels absorb energy from the sun. Power cables and couplers transfer this energy to the power distributor. The distributor powers the life support system, which creates oxygen that is piped to the living quarters. Damaged equipment is indicated by a colored icon on your map. You must repair our base and restore oxygen production. Go to the equipment shed to get supplies. There's work to be done.
We need to get the power network online as soon as possible. Pick up a welding torch at the equipment shed and start repairing those solar panels.
Move your mouse to look around the world. Walk using the W, A, S, and D keys. When you approach an object that you can interact with, it will glow. While the object is glowing, left click to interact with it.
Okay, if you haven't guessed, this is made by NASA, or published by NASA, I should say.
The equipment shed contains replacement equipment, tools, and robots. Access the equipment shed by left-clicking on it. Left-click on the tools category. Left-click on the welding torch, and then click the accept button. Now, you're ready to make repairs. Press M to open your map and locate an item that needs repairing. Use the arrow keys to move the map, and the plus and minus keys to zoom. Damaged equipment appears as a yellow, orange, or red icon. Press M again to close your map. Walk to the damaged item. It will have a colored, damaged icon floating overhead. The lights on the equipment display the power flow of the component. Green components are receiving power, red components are not. Left-click on a damaged item and select Repair. Press F1 at any time to access help and a complete list of game controls. This component has been damaged. The severity of damage affects the repair time. The repair circle tracks your repair progress. There is a potential bypass to the circuit that will save you repair time. Left click on one end of the circuit and move the mouse to solder a connection to the other end.
Thank you.
Come on. Could you stop glitching?
We just got a master alarm. Low oxygen level. We need a hold.
Power cable is attached, but the connection is not secured. Use a wrench to secure the connection. This component is heavily damaged and will take a long time to repair. Replacing it may be faster.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Thank you.
command center. You can remotely pilot rovers and use cameras to view various areas of the lunar base. Board the lunar rover by left-clicking on it and selecting drive.
What's going on?
Thank you.
bismuth. Do you copy? Can you provide a status on repairs?
The damaged solar array is just ahead. All of the components along a solar panel's power line must be functional before the power distributor receives energy. More energy means more oxygen. Fixing loose solar cell connections might save you repair time. Left click on one end of the solar cell and move the mouse to solder a connection to the other end.
Okay.
We
just got a master alarm. Low oxygen level. We need to hurry.
Can't even do it quick enough.
Excellent work. Continue to check for damage along the power network and use your welder to make repairs. Now I need that wrench. Oh no. There's one up there probably that I did. See if we can get this one going. This one line going. Yeah, I see it right there.
The power distributor and life support system are just ahead. Only robots can access this area because of the hazardous coolant leak. Repairing these systems increases efficiency.
What it's doing is it's spotting my mouse out to the side here and while I'm playing, so I'm clicking random things on this side.
create a customized robot that can safely approach the life support system and aid in your repairs.
Beta team, do you copy? Can you provide a status on repairs?
Right-click to drop the case. Left-click on the case and select Deploy to control the robot. Move the robot using the standard movement keys and left click to interact.
I need a welding torch guy. Keeps doing that.
Copy. Can you provide a status on repairs?
Well, I'm gonna leave this episode here. There's really nothing I can do. I just got the drone stuck, which is nice. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!